That's it, yeah. That's the story. Hello?
My child, I don't know if I've ever experienced a sin this great before, if I'm being honest. I don't even know if I can ask you if you wish to receive penance, because I don't know if it would even work. The chat has almost unanimously redeemed you to go to hell. How do you feel about that?
I mean, a bit shit, because I think hopefully that fish went to heaven, because the fish only served, you know, only did good for me, so hopefully the fish went to heaven. So if I go to hell, it's a bit upset because I'll never see that fish again. But
everybody in chat, Hail Mary for the fish. But unfortunately, Q, you are sentenced to hell. Straight to hell. What you did to this living being is unredeemable. Your sins are far too great for me to bless.
I know it's a sin, but how do we know the fish didn't enjoy it? How do we know the fish didn't enjoy its last moments like that? How do we know it wasn't sick of being a fish that would swim around in the ocean following its other fish? How do we know that I didn't save its life and gave it a purpose? And how do we know that it didn't die in peace? We don't know that. So I know I'm looking at it as a sin just because society portrays it that way, but why is it portrayed that way? We don't know that much about fish. All we know is that, you know, they're in the water, they can breathe underwater, they forget, they have loose memory. So that fish, because of its memory, what if it forgot that, you know, it got come down? What if it forgot? But I ain't saying nothing. That's what I'm saying, but, you know, fair enough. I'll go to hell.
Q, I am sorry. I hope the fish makes it to heaven, but unfortunately, you are damned to suck fish dick for the rest of eternity in hell.
Fish suck my dick, I didn't suck its dick.
I hope you have a blessed day, but unfortunately I will see you in hell.
Alright, see you there.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, fish fucker is straight to hell. Straight to hell. Straight to hell. I'm sorry.
子非鱼安之鱼之乐。 子非鱼安之鱼之乐。 这是一段来自庄子跟惠施的故事。 有一天，庄子跟惠施在好水的桥上散步。 庄子看着水中的鱼说：“鱼从容游于水中，就是鱼快乐的样子。” 惠施对庄子说：“你又不是鱼，你怎么知道鱼快乐了？”庄子说：“你又不是我，又怎么知道我不知鱼快乐了？”惠施说：“我不是你，当然不会知道你的想法，但你也不是鱼，所以也相同的无法知道鱼的想法啊。”庄子说：“回到根本的问题，当你问我怎么知道鱼快乐的时候，就代表会问这样问题的你已经知道我知道鱼是快乐的，而我知道鱼是快乐的这点是在豪桥上知道的。” 有点绕口令哈，也就代表惠施也依附着庄子说鱼是快乐的这点，再反问庄子你又知道鱼快乐了，也就是都有提到鱼是快乐的这点，而庄子又说他是依附在上桥时看到鱼的时候认为鱼是快乐的，又把问题丢回去给桥下那只鱼，阿鱼又不会说话，所以答案是无解的，任谁都不知道鱼是否快乐。 这个经典的地方在于话术，将问题丢回去那个问题点，就像自己都没提过，而是依附着问题点做判断的。因为鱼不会说话，所以就算有人做了判断，答案依然无解。结论在最后一句就变成你依附我，我依附于鱼不会说话，无解，就是这么的经典。 这样一来，问题自然就远离了庄子这个提出判断的人。水很深厚，但很有趣。人生上常常会有这样的事情，懂得运用话术，你就更胜一筹。对于圆场、混乱别人的思维、制造效果都有奇效，就在于你有没有仔细的分析过而已。 举个例子来玩玩，故事发生在我跟庄子在 DC 上聊天，我对庄子说，你看看会师天天都在玩游戏，天天都上线。庄子就跟我说，你又不是会师，你又如何知道说会师天天都在玩游戏？我就说，你也不是会师，你又如何知道说会师没天天在玩游戏？庄子说，我不是你，你也不是会师，只有会师本人最知道了。我说，你可以去问会师啊。庄子说，好啊。故事进入庄子问会师的环节，会师说，这样哦，因为我电脑不止我在使用，还有我弟，而且我 DC 设定开机自动上线，所以任谁开电脑都会显示我在线或玩游戏。庄子回来说，你看他没在玩游戏，只是因为开机自动上线，还有他弟弟在用电脑，所以你的认为是错误的。我说，好哦，但你看看他天天上线，且还有游玩的时间，这样大多数人也会认为他在玩游戏吧。庄子说，也是没错啦。这个结论是我的问题得以透过他人得到答复，我本人不用亲自去问，这种东西还可以加上更多的情绪表现，让对方可以更大机会的去替你问，透过激问反问来让对方更进入状况，进而想得到解答，而他想解答的目的是纯粹想跟你辩论，这时就可以透过这点让他替你问，他开心，你也能得到问题的解答，这就是文字的智慧，可以这么玩。当然他如果是回答懒得问，那事情当然是没结果的，但是可以从我编出来的庄子上得知，庄子可能是个好胜心强的人，将来可能会有所成就，之后可以跟他多玩玩这个，让他我都更进一步思考来辩论。好奇心、好胜心都可以助长知识的累积，过多当然也不好，容易做出危险的事情，过少经验累积的慢，适中就可以让自己的想法更多，创意也可从中累积，透过这样的变化自己求知的态度。说话也是一门艺术，每个人的方式都会吸引到有一样共鸣的人。我编的故事与庄子和惠施的故事都是针对单一情境做解释的，现实上还有很多变化的情境，一旦你累积的经验越多，越有办法透过这些事计算与人的相处与智谋，进而可掌握大局，且自己不用什么出面处理，事情自然就可成，只是像引导船头般运筹于帷幄之中，决胜于千里之外。啊，对了，当然这段的翻译角度也有很多不一样的解释，很多事情是一体多面的，如果读者有其他的想法可以提出来，我可以针对问题的角度再做解释，翻成实用的话术，人生经验分享给你们，迷音也是可以。如果喜欢我的分析，记得按赞、订阅加分享，让更多人来参与这个人生哲理的分析，让道更为完整。谢谢您的聆听，我们下次见。
Very good， 麦克风，一定是，不是大拇指就是，一定是大拇指了。没有大拇指的话，哪里有大拇指？